In this After Effects tutorial, we'll go through some basic expressions that help you in your everyday work. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel. Alright, let's get started with the index expression. We double-click on the rectangle tool to add a new shape. No fill, we use a stroke. Width, 2 pixels. Let's change the color, pink. We reduce the size and set it to 500 by 500 pixels. The index expression refers to the index number of a layer in the same comp. Let's open the rotation property of the shape and add an expression to it. Hold Alt or Option while clicking on the stopwatch symbol. And let's add in parentheses index plus 1. Let's quickly duplicate the layer a few times. Index plus 1 means look at the layer below. Plus 1, and by default subtract 1 of the rotation value. Let's add index minus 1 in parentheses instead. Again, we duplicate the layer a few times. Index minus 1 means look at the layer above, minus 1, and by default add 1 to the rotation value. So to increase the rotation, we need to multiply this value. Let's multiply it by 25, asterisk 25. By duplicating the shape again, we create this geometrical structure. Adding it to two-dimensional values is a bit different. We open the scale property, add an expression. We need to define a variable for each dimension. X equals, in parentheses, index minus 1, multiplied by 5, semicolon. Y equals, in parentheses, index minus 1, multiplied by 10, semicolon. Then we add an array and add the two variables inside. Square brackets, X, Y, both values start at 0, which is maybe a bit too small, so let's add two start values, 10 plus for the X value or the width, and 25 plus for the Y value or the height. Each time we duplicate the shape, the width is multiplied by 5%, starting at 10%. The height is multiplied by 10%, starting at 25%. Basic expressions and expressions in general make your life easier. Learn how to create complex animations with expressions in After Effects. In my new course, we start from zero. From basic expressions to responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. You'll have a whole set of new tools which will make you faster, better, and stand out from the crowd. Reasons enough to check out the course. Animating with expressions in After Effects. Link is in the description. With the valueAtTime expression, you can delay movements. I've animated the shape with 2 position keyframes. Let's duplicate the shape layer, Command or Control D, and add an expression to the position property. valueAtTime, and in parentheses, time minus 0.5. The animation is delayed by 0.5 seconds. The time is measured in seconds. Let's combine it with the index expression. We add an expression to the position property again. Add p equals, in parentheses, index minus 1, semicolon. The variable p is the index number of the layer above. Then valueAtTime, in parentheses, time minus p multiplied by 0.1. With each time we duplicate the layer, the animation is delayed by 0.1 seconds. Then let's add an expression to the opacity property. And add an index expression as well. 100 plus, in parentheses, index minus 1, multiplied by minus 10. With each time the layer is duplicated, the opacity goes down 10%, starting at 100%. Let's check it out. We duplicate the shape a few times. Awesome. The random expression, like the name says, returns random values. We use a square shape, add an expression to its opacity property, add random and in parentheses 50. The opacity animates randomly between 0 and 50. Each frame. 0 is the minimum value by default, 50 the maximum value. It's too fast, let's reduce the frame rate and add the posterize time expression before. Posterize time, 4 frames per second in parentheses, semicolon. That's way better. Let's add a different start value, 50. Then it's 50,100, for example. The opacity now animates between 50 and 100%. Let's add two two-dimensional values to arrays. We add an expression to the position property and reduce the frame rate to 4 frames per second. Then add a random expression, random, and in parentheses, square brackets, x500, y300. The first array, comma, the second array, x1400, y800. Let's add some guides to make clear what we've done. We drag the first one to x500, the next one to y300. Then to x1400, finally y800. We defined an area within which the shape moves, the center point of the shape to be exact. To learn more about expressions, check out my course. Link is in the description. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye everyone.